Alright guys. Hi, my name's Gosh from C6. Today we're gonna be playing Mountain Blade Bannerlord 2. We're gonna be roleplaying as a character that I have made, developed, roleplayed as already in a D&D campaign that I run for a group of friends. This character's name is Finwick. And Finwick is, the way I described him, is a, you know, he's above average on his height, above average on his build, and he was a half-elf. Obviously, I can't get the half-elf ears in Mountain Blade Bannerlord 2 unless I start installing mods, but this is a completely vanilla playthrough of Mountain Blade Bannerlord 2, right? No mods, no nothing. I'm just gonna get into it. I have played Mountain Blade Bannerlord 2 before. I bought it once it was fully released. I didn't participate in the alpha or anything like that, but I do know a little bit about it. Obviously, I don't know a lot because I haven't been playing it that long, but I want to start getting some videos out. I want to start doing, like, you know, little role-playing videos, let's play videos, little series, I should say, where I play these characters. And again, this series is going to be around Finwick. Finwick, little backstory on him is he was raised in a very large city. The city had an arena, like a gladiatorial style arena, right? You go in, you compete in these games, winner gets money. It was a, you know, if you win, you don't die. If you lose, the whole emperor style thing, thumbs up, thumbs down, you know what I'm saying? Where you have a chance of dying. So Finwick joined these arena games at a very young age. He wanted to help provide for his family. Like I said, his family was not very well off, right? So he wanted to help provide for his family. The only way he knew how to do that was either steal or do it the right way and be a gladiator or go join the army or go join a militia group or, you know, mercenaries, things like that, right? Well, he joined the arena and he got very, very good at these arena games. So much so that his entire fortune and his entire popularity in the world of Mareliona, which is where my D&D campaign is held. It's a completely homebrew thing I got going on with that. But that's where he got all his popularity. That's where he got all his money. And that's who we're going to be roleplaying as. Alright, this is the best representation of what I could get Finwick to look like in Mountain Blade Bannerlord 2. As close as he could be to what my D&D visualization of him is, you know? Alright. The backstory on how he got to Cal Radio. My party in D&D, they work for this guy. This guy gives them jobs. They are an adventuring group, mercenary group, however you want to say it. Well, things didn't go as planned for Mr. Finwick. Okay? Finwick, you know, things went astray, and he decided to leave. He got on a boat, and he sailed to the far distant shores, and ended up in Cal Radio. Alright? The way I'm gonna do his backstory is his family, right? His, you know, the brother, the younger brother, the younger sister that you get. Well, I'm gonna say he got here, right? Things went astray back in Mareliona, where he's from. And he went and joined the forest people. He had his time in the limelight. He had his time in fame. Now he just wants to get away. He wanted to get away from it all. Well, during that time, as he, you know, washed ashore in Calradia, he got to the center where the Tanians were, and a family found him. And that's gonna be his family. His family is the family who brought him in his biggest time of need, right? And they're gonna be bards. You know, like I said, Finwick, at one point he did join the Thieves Guild, but he didn't really like it. So he's gonna have a little roguery experience. I honestly don't know how roguery works in this game. But he'll have a little roguery experience, and he is very, very good with people. You have to be good with people when, you know, you're the champion of the arena, you're leading mercenary groups, you're hiring adventuring groups, you know, you gotta talk to people, get them to do what you want them to do. So bards are good at talking to people. Especially in D&D, you know? And that's what my role-playing experience is from, so. As a child, again, this is back when he was a young child. He wasn't known for his brawn. He did join the arena, but I would say his way with people. He was good at talking to people. And that's how he got his way into the arena. As a child, he, you know, he helped hunt small game to help put food on the table before he joined the arena. He'd go into the wilderness and, you know, shoot, capture animals for his family so they have something to eat. Now, as a youngster growing up in Calradia, this is after he got here, right? So, yeah, everything that's happened in my D&D world, he's moved on. He got to Calradia. He's now in Calradia. As a youngster growing up in Calradia, what did he do? Well, he's very good with a sword and shield, coming back from his, you know, gladiatorial upbringings, if you will. And this family, you know, they may not have been as well off. They may not be in well off enough to bring him in, but they did. Out of the kindness of their hearts. So he wants to help protect them. So I'm going to say, I'm going to say he joined the Kern, okay? Many Batanians fight as a Kern, versatile troops who can both harass the enemy line with their javelins or join in the final screaming charge once they're weakened. I don't want to say he trained with the infantry, because I really just don't see that. But I also kind of do want to say the infantry, because, you know, sword and shield, frontline battle, you know, that's what he's used to. So, yeah, I actually am going to say infantry, because I do want a point in vigor. He trained with infantry in a small Batanian village. Helped protect the, you know, his family that brought him in. He helped provide for them in a way that, the only way he really knows how. He doesn't know anything about this world, but he knows how to fight. Before he set on his life as an adventurer, like I said, he's really good with people. So he didn't want to go out there and, like, conquer the world through his combat escapades like he did in Mareliona. No. He just wanted to treat people good so he would get treated good. Like many families in Calradia, your life was upended by war. Your home was ravaged by the passage of army after army. Eventually, you sold your property and set off with your father, mother, brother, and your two younger siblings. Like I said, the father-mother thing, it's just the family that brought him in. And the older brother and the two younger siblings, you know, they were very much brother, sister. Because they brought him in, they cared for him when no one else would. He's in a new place. So he would very much see them as like your brother-sister types, you know. Like I said, with his Thieves Guild upbringing, I would say he found a way to let the travelers break out. You know, bards, you know, they have a way of getting themselves in trouble. So his family, they go to this inn, and you know, the bards are doing their bard thing, and you know, they get themselves in a little bit of trouble. Some raiders come through, and you know, Finwick in here, all he wants to do is protect that family. So he organized a way that they could get out. Obviously, everyone didn't make it, but you know, he did his best. Can't blame Finwick for everything, right? Except his name is Finwick. Okay. He is of the culture of Batania. His family were bards, early childhood, very good with people. He hunted small game. Alright. So this is going to be Finwick. Like I said, I have played this game before, so I see no point in not playing on the hardest difficulty, because everything I do, I'm a degenerate. So everything I play on the hardest difficulty, because I'm dumb. So that's what we're going to do. Battle death for all heroes is going... And they annual battle of death for all heroes. Yep. So Finwick can very much die. I don't want this to be like Finwick is invincible. Or the people he, you know, hires later on. I don't want them to be invincible either. I want this to be hard. I would not do Iron Man mode because this is my first set of videos on YouTube here. I don't know how the recording is going to look. I don't know how the audio is going to sound. I may have to go back and record some things, you know. So I don't want to do Iron Man mode. But I do want it to be as hard as possible without the Iron Man mode. So here we go.
Brother, it's been 3 days now we've been tracking those bastards. I think we're getting close. We need to think about what happens when we catch them. How are we going to rescue our brother and sister? Are we up for a fight?
My brother looks weird. He looks like a Viking, not a forest guy.
This looks like an old training field for the legions. Perhaps we can spare some time and brush up on our skills. The practice could come in handy when we catch up with the raiders.
Like in the background, he's just beating the shit out of something. I am going to do the tutorial, however, I'm not going to do the tutorial because I've already done it. So I'm just going to say continue tutorial and exit. Just for story purposes, you know? And I'll also be role-playing Finwick's voice, so... This looks like an old infantry training option. Perhaps, blah blah, okay. I'm going to run the course. I need to know if I can fight if I have to.
Let's go on, then.
Like I said, I'm not doing this. Before we do anything else, we're low on food. There's a village north of here. We can buy provisions and find some help. You're a better rider than I am, so I'll let you lead the way. Alright, let's go. That is turned off. I've played this tutorial so many times without knowing how to turn that off. Like I said, he is a guy who is very famous for winning tournaments in the arena. That was his old life, not his new life, but I would say, you know, put him in that limelight again. He's gonna do it. I don't necessarily see Finwick as, like, leading massive armies, per se. You know, he'll lead if he has to, but it's not gonna be anything crazy. But he is a good leader. Don't get that confused. I don't see him meeting massive armies with the stewardship skill, but he is a good leader. So, I'm going to put it in leadership. That's how I see Finwick going forward.
Well, we're here, I guess. So, we need food, and after that, maybe some men to come with us. The head man here can probably help us. Let's try to find him.
I'm gonna be 100% honest with you guys, I am not very good on horseback. Ow. Like I said, it is what it is. I'm good at the sword and shield.
I'm Orthos, head man of this village. What brings you here?
What brings you here? We need help. Some raiders have taken our younger brother and sister captive. I think they may have passed this way.
They got your people too? Sorry to hear that. Those bastards have done a bit of killing and looting in these parts as well. We think they've gone north. I reckon there are a few folk around here who'll join you in going after them if you'll pay for their gear. Once you've made your preparations, come and talk to me again. I may have a task for you if you're going after the raiders.
What the fuck is this guy doing? Well, that guy on his right's freaking me out. I kind of want to kill him, but, that's just me. Alright, recruit troops. We're gonna recruit them all. Buy products, we need food for our troops. Finish our preparation. Let's go talk to this guy.
Glad to see you found what you needed. Now, about that master I mentioned earlier.
Right.
There's this wandering doctor who comes through it from time to time. Name of Tactius. Treats people for free. We're fond of it.
Yeah, but you're fond of anything that is free.
Well, we last saw him a few days ago. He was carrying some sort of chest, which he was very mysterious about.
Yo, look at this.
He was on some sort of quest, he said.
And then she had the audacity to look back, like it was his fault. What the hell? You ran into him.
He set off on the road just a few hours before the raiders came through here. Well, he's not really a worldly type. Just the kind of fellow who'd stumble into a trap and let himself be captured. We're worried about him. If you can keep an eye out for him, this Tactius, we'd be very grateful. Maybe if he's alive and well, he'll tell you a little more about his quest.
Right. So we'll help find this Tactius guy. Tactios. Like I said, he fights when he needs to, if he thinks it is going to help people. I'm fond of the famous meta of F1, F3, so...
Charge!
Plus, just a tutorial, these troops don't really matter. They go away after tutorial. Yeah! Oh my god, I hit a guy. I am very bad on horseback, but you don't understand. How did he block a spear with an axe, dude? That guy's insane. I need to recruit that guy. Okay. Alright. I take it you guys got this? Oh my god. He killed my horse guy. Oh, I got him. Get on. Right, got some troops. Got some fucking. If I remember correctly, you don't get to keep any of this either, do you? I don't remember. I'm pretty sure you don't, though. Where are these raiders at? There they are. I want the first hit. Just because I'm not comfortable. I want the first hit. The best combat tactic in the game. I'm only very happy about this, but I suck at horseback. Oh my god! Get on. Not the best. More troops, more prisoners. We're gonna sell them off. Alright. Like I said, I don't think we get to keep this, but, you know. Where are those other raiders at? Oh! My scouting skill must be, like, terribly low right now. Because I can't see them for anything, dude. Alright. sure what that battle lag was about, but we're just gonna go with it for now.
I don't know who you are, but I'm in your debt. These brigands would have marched us to our deaths. My name's Tactios. I'm a doctor by trade.
So we found
Tactios,
yeah.
Well, a bit of a quest, but I'm now thinking I'm not really made for this kind of thing. I was with a caravan, and they just came out of the brush. We were surrounded and outnumbered, so we gave up. I figured they'd keep us alive, if just for the ransom. But then they started flogging us along at top speed, without any water, and I was just about ready to drop. I could feel the signs of heatstroke creeping up, and I told them, but they just flogged me more. If your group hadn't come along, maybe I have a way to thank you properly.
We're looking for two children, captured by the raiders. Can you tell us anything?
I'm afraid I haven't seen any children, but after our caravan was attacked, the chief of the raiders, the one they call Radagos, took and rode off with our more valuable belongings, including a chest that I had. He seemed to be controlling more than one band around this area. If this lot has your kin, then I think he'd be the one to know. And since I have nothing of value left to repay your help, I'll tell you this. If you do catch up with and defeat that ruffian, you may be able to recover my chest. It contains a valuable ornament, which I was told could be of great value if you knew where to sell it. I was trying to find out more about it, but, as I say, I've had all my urge for travelling flogged out of me. Right now, I don't think I'd venture more than 20 paces from a well as long as I live. It doesn't look like much, and I suspect this lot will give it away for a few coins. But I got it from a mercenary whom I treated once, and he swore it was related to Neritzi's folly. I don't know what that means, except that Neritzi's was, of course, the emperor who died in battle some years back. Maybe you could find out its true value. Thanks for saving me again. I hope our paths will cross again.
Me too, man. Me too. Alright, how am I already back at 50? Is that just like a tutorial thing? Alright, nice save. Why'd he even tell me? It told, like, the question mark's here, dude. I can't even wait in the tutorial. Oh, this is bad. I'm about to go in this fight with, like, no HP. Alright, I'm gonna try to adjust some settings, so maybe, I don't know if it's my recording or, you know, what's happening. I do not want to lag in the middle of a fight. I also tried to lower this as much as I feel, you know, comfortable with lowering it, because, you know, I really just want to put out some videos, but I also don't want the game to look like complete dog. But yeah, I don't want it to look terrible, but I also don't want to just be a laggy mess, you know what I'm saying? So, we'll see. I have a 2080 Ti, 11900K, so I don't have a terrible computer, but I also don't have, like, the best computer, you know? But it says it's not using, like, any of my GPUs, so I don't know why my recording would suck. I don't know. We'll see where it goes, what happens. no waiting? Alright, well, we're going to the fight with Hathel, so... Good luck, us. I don't have a shield.
Die!
Oh wait, F1, F3. I kind of want one of these guys to die. It's a terrible thing to say, but I really want a shield. So when I go fight this guy, dude, I really want a shield. Unless someone else is down here on the shield. Let's see. Very nice speed, too, aren't they? I got this. My brother's kind of a beast. That guy's kind of a beast. Okay, how do we at least do that shit? Now, Finwick is very much a man of honor, so when he's challenged to a 1v1...
So, who's this that comes through my place of business, killing my employees?
We heard you took our little brother and sister. Where are they?
Good heaven. I'll need a better description than that. My men have harvested dozens of little brats in this region. Quite good hunting grounds. Already sent most of them off to a slave market, I know, though.
Yeah, this guy seems like a little stand-up gentleman.
Since your hunt for your kin is fruitless, how about you clear off and save your own lives? Either that, or I'll force you to lick up all the blood you've spilled here with your tongues. Or you and I could settle this one-on-one.
Like I said, Finwick, he's a man of honor. That's part of his core code and ethics. So he's challenged to a duel. You best believe Finwick, the master duelsman that he is gonna take that. Very well. I'll duel you. That was a killing scream, by the way. Not me. I win. Get on. Alright, like I said, I don't think the prisoner thing or anything else like that matters, but... Nothing better. Knobbed club. I'm pretty sure
well,
it takes it all.
I recognize defeat when I see it.
Yeah, you better.
If I'm gonna be your captive, let me introduce myself. I'm Radagos.
Hello, Radagos.
You haven't cut my throat yet, which was a wise move. I'm sure I can find a way to be worth more to you alive than dead.
You better help us get our brother and sister back, or you'll swing from a fucking tree.
Ah, you'll need my help, all right. If you want to get them back. Alive, that is. See, my boys have some pretty specific instructions about what to do if there's a rescue attempt.
What would those instructions be exactly?
Shall we get on the road? Remember, if I drop dead of exhaustion or drown in some river, that's it for your little dears. I don't expect a cozy palanquin now, but you best not make it too hard a trip for me.
I like how this guy's setting up demands when he's captured. come across a chest with an odd old piece of bronze in it. It's so battered and corroded that it could have been anything from a cup to a crown. This must be the chest that Tactios mentioned. That had something to do with Nezra's folly? Finwick wouldn't know anything about this. You know, he's new to these lands.
I was hoping to find more treasure here, but I think business wasn't going too well for Radagos and his gang. I found this strange-looking metal piece, though. Doesn't look too valuable, but it could be the artifact Tactios was talking about.
Tactios.
Maybe we can sell it to one of the noble clans for a hefty price.
Maybe. All right. Let's get on the road, then.
I have a better idea. We would have a better chance if we split up now. I'll take Radagos and go find the slaver market and look for a way to free the children. However, we must be careful not to endanger their lives, and it could be better to just buy them. We need to have our purses full for that, though. I'll need to take these men with us. Radagos is a slippery one. I don't want him getting away.
So you want me to raise the money to ransom the little ones?
Indeed. You'll have to find a way to do that. Maybe this bronze thing can help. Tactios said it could be worth a fortune to the right person, if you manage not to get killed. If he's telling the truth, you must be careful. Never reveal that you have it, but try to understand its value and how it can be sold.
Oh, and how am I going to do that, guys?
One more thing. When you are talking to nobles and other people of importance, make sure you present yourself as someone from a distant but distinguished family.
Yeah, and it's good that, you know, he's mentoring Finwick, because Finwick doesn't know anything about this land. So, I think it's good that, you know, he is giving him some pointers here.
You can use our family name if you like, or make up a new one. You will have a better chance of obtaining an audience with nobles, and it'll be easier for me to find you by asking around.
Yeah, we're not going to use that. What was Finwick's last name? I don't even remember. Finwick. What is the bronze worth? All right.
Get on the road now. Once I locate the little ones, I'll come find you.
So this really cool mod where like you can, I think it's called like copy paste mod or copy banner paste mod. You can like fully edit this thing. I think that's really cool. Like I said, this is a vanilla playthrough, so we don't have any of that. We are Britannians, so we want to be green. I think the green and the yellow is a very nice look. Tutorial is over. We are now free to explore Calradia. Yeah. All right, so we got 3 in leadership, 3 in charm. Like I said, he's very comfortable with a sword and shield, so I kind of want to put some points in sword and shield. Until we start reaching, like, learning limits, you know. Maybe I should put it in medicine, actually. No, I know, or athletics, actually. Oh, my God. Never mind. Yeah, athletics is very important. I need to put a point in endurance. I need to have at least 3 in that for sure. Like I said, I will not be going with smithing. The smithing is, I don't know if I said this actually, but smithing is kind of in a state where it's kind of broken. So I really don't want to do smithing because, like I said, it is broken. So they're probably going to do some fixing to that, but we'll see. So I don't know why. cunning? I don't know why I'm cunning so low. I'm part of the Thieves Guild, dude. But I also don't know what roguery does. I think these two will definitely be maxed, though. These two maxed. Maybe a point here. Definitely a point here. Kind of want everything to be at least three, you know? Well evened out character. But this is what we'll start with. And we are now free to explore everything on our own. Turn the audio up a little bit. I don't think the music is loud enough for everybody. Let me know if the volume is too loud. We'll fix that. Let's try that. Alright, let's take note of what we got going on. So, Batanians are way over here. I wish the campaign would start you in your town. I don't know why it does not. But, my first playthrough, I did do a Viking playthrough because I'm really fond of Vikings. And running all the way up here in the campaign, that's tough. When you're like level one, you have no army with you, it's tough. It's real bad. Alright, so we go back to this town. You know, we found the guy that they wanted us to find. They do have another quest. We were also given a quest to establish our claim. So we need 1,000 dinars. Party size of 20. Reach clan tier 1 and hire a companion. We do need a companion now that our brother's gone. We have no one to teach us what to do in this world. This is a new world to us. What's he need? Deliver herd.
Well, good day to ya. So, who might you be?
Is this the same guy that we talked to in the tutorial? My name's Finwick, sir. May I ask your name? Oh, voice acting's gone. I'm Vadrios. Vadrios? I've lived all my life here, working the land as do my kin. A lot of the people here in Tavia, the common farmers and craftsmen like me, they'd like me to speak for them. Well, I heard you might need some help with a problem. Well, some of the families in the village need to raise a bit of money. They put together a herd of 10 sheep to sell in Onira. With all the banditry on the roads, they can't drive there on their own. We're not merchants or landowners, we can't afford any losses. Alright, tell me how I can help. If you go in the direction of Onira, you could perhaps take our herd there. I'm willing to pay 900... what is it, deniers? If you deliver them safe and sound. Any other way, you can sign a companion. Well, I don't really have a companion. Alright, fine, don't worry. I'll deliver your sheep personally. Too low. I don't know. This is gonna be like my first video, so I'll work out some kinks along the way. Alright, oh, we need troops. Alright, we're not gonna get troops. We're fine. If I had a bow, things would be a lot better, because you know, you could just pick off the guys. But, here we are, suffering from success of not having a bow. Also, why is he so slow? Herd? Oh, the sheep. Right. Right. Alright, well, I guess I should buy a horse, or a mule. Do I still have the herd? Yeah, I do. Oh my god, bro. We're getting owned. Oh, did I keep the gloves? Yeah, like I said, I didn't keep the gloves. That's fine. Okay, here we are. Yo, where are all the troops at? At least I'm somewhat moving now. Better than before. Thanks for that one man. I need 20, by the way. Oh, I'm dead.
Hey, what have we here? There's a tax for passage in these parts, traveler.
Oh,
paid either in coin or in blood.
Ah, maybe we can work something out. I don't have the man to fight you right now. Splendid. See, my lads and I were not cruel men. Bit greedy, though. Can't be denied. So be generous. What does he want? Oh, that's not bad. I could probably do that. Yeah. You know, unfortunate circumstances. Why is there already a group of 28 looters? I just started the game. And there's no troops anywhere. What? I'm getting owned. There's no way around that. I'm just getting owned. Are they at war? Is that what's happening here? They just recruiting all the troops before I even get a chance? Oh.
You! Stop! Give us your silver! We're not playing games!
Yo, we're gonna fight this guy. Yeah. 12? I can handle 12. I don't have a bow, which is an issue. And I am very bad on horseback, which is also an issue. Maybe. Just maybe. We can do this. Alright. We can't do that.
Victory!
Oh my god. Alright, Finwick, you know, he's new to this land. He's not having a great time here. Finwick's gone through some stuff in his life. I don't know what else to say about that. Finwick is a... It's a rough world out there for Finwick. Oh, I escaped. That was quick. Thank goodness. I just need some friends, dude. I need a bow as well. I don't know why I didn't start off with a bow. I got some recruits now, though. We'll be fine. Everything's fine. Alright. That should be good for now. And there is a tournament. So, like I said, Finwick did get his rise to fame through tournaments. So, if he has to earn money, what better way than doing it the way he knows best? Only one lord, okay. Helmet with face guard. It's very imperial-esque. We do need a bet, because we are broke. We can't bet very... Oh, they gave me a bow. I'm dead. I'm so bad. I need to not get killed by this horse. It's a rough start for Finwick. I'm not gonna lie to anybody here. Finwick is having the worst of times right now. Who's that guy? Just chilling with 85 people. Hanging out. Oh! I never
found
this early.
Come no closer. Forgive me, but one cannot be too cautious. I would ask you for your name.
Hello, my name's Finwick. May I ask yours? I'm Regia, rightful Empress of the Calradians. I am Lady of Lycarion and Onira. I have not heard of you, but you have the look of a man who might make something of himself one day. Right. I'm here to deliver my demands. This quest that we have to do. Yeah, I got this thing, and I don't know what that is. Well, that's what some people call the Great Battle of Pendraic in the year 1077. Emperor Netzes, that guy, led an army accompanied by Khazates and Assyri to fight a coalition of Sturgeons. Not the Vikings, dude, and the Batanians! Oh, no. It was a disaster for him. He died in it. But the victors didn't fare much better. I see. Can you tell me anything about this battle? Of course. I did not witness the battle, but my husband spoke frequently of it. He was not one of the Emperor's trusted commanders. He was one of the Emperor's trusted commanders. He could not stop Nestris from marching to defeat, but he managed to salvage something from disaster. When the Sturgeons came over our barricades, he managed to lead a group of guardsmen out the back. Ah, nice. Husband's small force held together and were joined by stragglers. Stragglers and fugitives. He described the march back. No food, little water, marching day and night to keep ahead of the enemy's outriders. But they survived. The only organized imperial force to do so. Oh my god, your husband's a genius. The city was in a state of panic after hearing rumors of what happened. Arnikos kept things from descending into chaos when it came time for the Senate to choose the next emperor. There's no question that it should be him. I loved him before as a man, but that day, learned to love him as something more. What a gift he was to the people of Calradia. So you're a gold digger. Got it. Alright, I'm out of here. It's a pleasure to meet you, shawty. I gotta get some money. Real bad. I need to go deliver my stuff. Okay.
Well, then who do we have here?
I like this guy's voice.
Would you care to tell me your good name?
Wait. I don't like the way you're speaking to me like I'm a piece of meat, but my name's Finwick, sir. May I ask yours? Maybe on a merchant here. Ah! I was told to, I hear you recently caught some bandits. Speaking as a merchant, we appreciate your efforts. Not necessarily did I capture any bandits. Unless you're speaking about Radagos. Yeah, I did do that. But I technically got caught. about this task, though. Yes, sir. Yep. Wait. Oh, no, they took my sheep. Or did my men eat the sheep? And let me guess, no one's gonna sell sheep. I am broker than a joke right now, dude. And it saved. That's good.
Yeah? You want something from me? Who are you?
My name's Finwick, sir. I need some help. I need a loan. One one-handed axes. Okay. And you'll give me 2,000 gold. I'll do that for you. I need a place where I can buy sheep. Alright, I need to fight these people. I need to get these one-handed axes, right? And I also need to get these sheep real bad. There's some sheep right there. Yo, I can't catch this guy? What's happening here? I'm fast.
Back off, stranger. Unless you want trouble.
I don't mind, brigand. Surrender or die. Alright, let's see if this goes better than the last fight. I'm on a horse. Surely, my spear reaches longer than whatever they got going on. Oh, yeah. F1, F1. Oh, my God. Help me. Oh, man, I'm so bad. But I distracted him long enough for my men. Let's go.
Die, you bastard!
It was all a ploy. I never knew. Yeah. Yep. Oh, yeah. And we got a prisoner. Oh wait, now my boots are better. I need a hood. Okay. I'll be honest, this is probably the roughest start I've ever had in this game. I'm not saying that just to say it. I promise it's the worst start I've ever had. How much are your sheep, sir? I'll sell you my mules for some sheep. I sell my mules, I can only get 2 sheep, though. Didn't I just get some gear? Oh, my God. Didn't it not buy said gear? Or did I fuck up? Very possible I fucked up. Yep. This is good. This is real good. I can't afford anything. Oh man. And I can't catch this guy. I'm gonna be chasing him for years. His speed is 3.7, mine's 4.9. Explain to me how I've not caught this man yet.
We're just armless travelers.
My pole arm was longer than their sword. It only makes sense. My archer not archering? I got 39 gold. Nice. And a prison. Also, I think I did fuck up. Because I don't have any of that loot that I had. I needed that. We also need to fight this guy.
Stop right there! This...
Like, we need... We need it bad. I need my archer to...
Archers! Forward!
Like, I need you to shoot, buddy.
Make a shield wall! Infantry!
Nope. I'm so
make a shield wall!
Nice shield wall. Alright, let me go distract him again. Dude, maybe I'm good on a horse, but maybe I lied. Maybe I'm figuring out this pole arm. The thing's long. I just gotta play distance. Oh. How did that rot do 19 damage? Hello? Do this, man. 9 damage. Alright, boys, it's not looking good. I'll be honest, it's not looking good at all. Can I pick up his bow? I can, right? If I can lead them away, I can pick up the bow and play with the bow on horseback. I feel like that gives me the best chance of success here. I just need to lead them very far away. So by the time I get back, you know, they're not on my ass. I'll just run over here. Pick up the bow.
Bow's not there.
Oh no. We're ruined. They have pitchforks. Alright, we can do this. Finwick, you can do this. Never mind. Finwick, you can't do this. You're dead. Is there not a bow? Where's the bow? There is a shield. Oh, man. Have you ever seen a worse Bannerlord player? I don't think you have. Oh, man. I don't think anyone's ever witnessed a worse Bannerlord player ever in their life. I'm so scared of their pitchfork. Alright, we got a hit. Let's go. Why is Finwick got blood all over his hand when he knows he hasn't killed like but one man? I'm so slow on this horse too. That's what makes things even worse. Alright. There's only 3 of them left now. I think we got one of the ones with a pitchfork. Oh, yeah, baby, let's go. We're doing this. Finwick, you're a freaking genius. You just gotta run around them, dude. They can't catch a horse. He looks anything, he's smart, you know? Oh, yeah. Oh, I think we won this. I should just pick up a shield and fight this man. And, you know, we're getting a lot of good experience on riding. Maybe our horse won't be... Hello? Can you just block that with a dagger? This guy's better than you in every way. Oh. I'm getting owned by an AI. I'm so bad at the game. Holy shit. Okay, we're getting some renown. That was good. That was good renown right there. Are they wounded? Oh, nice. I thought I lost them for sure. Alright. We need some more armor. That's good. And some butter. Also very good. Okay. Nope. Let's take that. We need to sell it. And get some motherfucking sheep, bro. How long do I have this quest? Time remaining, 21 days. Oh, okay. We're fine. We're actually fine. I should kill them. These sheep are 50. Oh, so that's 4 sheep right there, right? We need 9? We're gonna do this. We're gonna get our money, right? We're gonna get our money. So we're gonna go back. We made that man a promise. We would deliver these sheep.
Hey, oh, why are we God. Here?
Fight me. Alright. Alright, my archer's alive. That's massive. Alright. I need to not mess this up. I need to weaken them. Heavily before it gets my man. And when I say I need to weaken them heavily, I mean I need to hit them. That would be ideal. Yep. Oh my god, I'm getting killed by rocks. It's gonna be the most embarrassing thing I've ever witnessed in my life. I also need my archer to freaking shoot!
Archers! Forward!
Shoot, you buffoon. Alright. We're just poking them. And our archer's gonna do the rest. Oh my god.
Charge!
They're hitting my horse. Thank God that guy didn't kill me.
Infantry, kill them all!
Oh, my men are doing work right now, dude. Yes! Yes! Let's go! That guy did die, which is unfortunate. But it's okay. And we got some olives. Okay. We do some trading. Wrapped shoes, leather shoes, pilgrim hood, red pilgrim hood. Okay. Yes, sir. Let's go deliver these sheep. Because we made a promise. And our promises matter here at Cal Radio. But I also need a man. Recruit, please. Why are they selling? I don't want that. No, I need a regular dude. Hello? Also, I don't even know if I want to level these guys up because like it costs so much money and I'm broke. I have a herd again. So I'm slow. I'm so slow. Everything's bad. This whole game. This game wants me to fail. That 15 looter thing? That's a problem. That's also a problem. Yep. These are the the guys with throwing weapons, isn't it? Why is my archer facing the wrong way every fight? And of course the bow's not there. Yeah, boys, I don't see us winning this one. I'll be honest. We're gonna get pummeled by rocks before we do anything about this. Yo, these guys are murderers with their freaking rocks. Good hits in. The issue is, I don't think I'm gonna survive many more rocks, and there's so many of them. Yeah. All right, so this is the second time Finwicks has been captured. Someone save me, please. So, do they take... Alright, that's what we want there. Probably put another point riding, just because we're on a horse. And our horse back sucks. They do take your sheep. That is insane. They just take my sheep. How many days do I have left on this fucking quest? I promise I will complete this quest if it's the last thing I do. Oh wait, no. Yeah. I need a bow real bad. They don't have a cheap bow. Ooh, boy. Or recruits. I'm having the worst of times. I thought games were supposed to be fun. I'm playing the victim here. Alright, this guy needs a quest. What does he need? Manual laborers. I guess my prisoners are gone too. Yep, that makes sense. Wait, what do these town people need? Fencing stolen goods. Oh, I can't really do that either. I need to be full health. If we're ever gonna survive, I need to be full health. Look, there's 18 looters. I am playing the victim. That's my only role in this game. How about this one? 17 days. don't think I've ever seen a worse start to Mountain Blade Bannerlord than I've ever seen today. I need to get at least somewhat close to this town, so when I do eventually get all these sheep, you know, we're close. First, I need these men, and we need to find bandits. And we need to fight our way. Awesome, I'm out of grain, dude. No! They're gonna start eating my... Products. I need. Okay. Yep. Now we need to fight. Alright, when I want to fight, there's not there. But when I don't want to fight, you know, I'm just getting pummeled. Oh my goodness, dude. I gotta sell one of my donkeys. You know, my brother leaving me was probably the worst thing he could have ever done to me. I'll be honest.
You got a problem?
Alright, we got some bandits. Okay. Yeah, they started right next to us. What the hell?
Come on!
Hey. Yeah, get on. Thought you were about to hit me, but you weren't.
Die!
Yep. Oh, my horse. Better him than me, let's be honest. We just gotta soften them up before they get to our guys. Our guys can handle this, I think. We need to soften them. Lost no one. That is wonderful. We got 41 gold from that. We got a prisoner. Okay. Yo, they don't have shit for us, do they? I like that. Finwick looks good, bro. This is gonna be a long video, just because I'm trying to complete this one quest. What do you need? Oh no. I can't play your games. Sea Raiders. They have a shield for me. I know they do. Okay. They're fast as fuck. I don't know what else to say. What do you need? Trained troops?
Hey, so who?
Alright. Hear me out here. That gave me free troops, right? What troops did they give me? Oh, I need bowmen. Alright, that's all we can afford right now. Borrow troops, and they're just basic Joe Smoes. Alright. Oh, I need... Oh, my God. Now I'm going... Oh, there's an arena. Oh, I don't have no money. Wait, I do have money. I have things to sell. Alright, this is... 1,000 IQ is go to this arena... Bet all the money I have and win. I got a friend on my team. And I have a sword and shield. So I don't lose this. Okay. Let's go! Like I said, Finwick is a master of the arena. There is a lord here, which is not good for me. But... do I have any more money? Yep, let's go. Go. Good distraction, my partner in crime there. Yep, alright. This is unfortunate. Not gonna lie. Lord in the final round against Finwick. Good news is this guy is absolute dog water at the game, dude. Oh man, you're lucky I'm not toxic. Is there a crouch button in this game? Oh my gosh, she's fast. Oh, it doesn't matter. One more hit, she's done for. Let's go! Like I said, this is how Finwick wins. This is how he got his money in the first place. How he get his money now. And we got some armor out of that. Yes, we needed that bad. You have no idea how bad we needed that. Applaud, please. I really think the flex is just better, so we're gonna go with that. I also need my endurance up one more. That's probably where it's gonna stay at for the remainder. It might go up one more, but I really want to do, like, you know, social. Tactics would not be bad to have at least two in, you know? Also, I need a bow. I'm getting... I think that's best. We're doing a lot of combat right now. I need to go get these freaking sheep, bro. How many sheep do I need? 6 more sheep. 400 gold. Alright, and we go deliver this quest. Right? Get our money from that.
It's been a while.
I brought your 10 sheep. Overall, we probably did not make very much money from that. But we gave that man our word. Alright, and this guy, what did he need again? He needed, one-handed axes. So I paid 400 and got 2,000 for that. 100% worth it. Never not worth it. But I'm gonna go ahead and end the video there. You know, Finwick had a rough time there for a while, but we got our feet under us. Okay, you know, we got captured by bandits like twice. We got incapacitated. They stole our sheep like 5 times. We had to buy sheep. We were getting owned. But it's about the it's about the journey, you know? The destination, it doesn't matter. The journey is what mattered, and we have journeyed. I want to thank anybody who watches this video. If you have any pointers, like volume too loud, anything like that, please do let me know. Video is probably going to be quite long. Anyone who does watch this, I hope you enjoy, and I hope to see you again. And yeah, have a good one. Thank you.